My name is Captain Rob White. I'm with the Broad River Fire Department, and I'm making this video as an overview of how to clean your structural PPE after it's gotten, it got soiled at a fire or a motor vehicle accident or maybe even an EMS call. So the stand, look this up and see what the latest standard is on how to take care of your gear. It's NFPA 1851. Also, look at the tags on each piece of equipment and see what the cleaning instructions are on those. By default, you always go back to what does the tag say on your equipment. For example, my gloves, my cleaning instructions are no machine wash. My hood is machine wash warm water. These are both machine wash warm water. The helmet is removing my neck protector and all of the padding in here. You remove it all and then you use a mild detergent to scrub the whole thing. The neck protector can be machine washed. So this is my spare set of gear. I've already emptied all the pockets. So before you wash your gear, get everything out of the pockets. Make sure there's no gross contaminants in the pockets. Hopefully, you're doing a gross decon or a routine cleaning at the fire scene before you come back to the firehouse and prep your gear for washing. So I'm gonna backstep a little bit. So we've got three different kinds of cleaning that are taught in fire service for your gear. You have routine, advanced, and specialized. So the routine cleaning is It's kind of like doing spot cleaning. It would be the same thing as doing your gross decon out at the fire scene. So getting somebody to wash you off with low pressure water, getting any gross contaminants off your stuff before you come back from the fire scene. That's routine. The advanced cleaning is what I'm getting ready to show you how to do and put it in our machine here at Broad River. And then the specialized would be if you have some kind of chemical contaminant on your PPE, or you have biocontaminants. Most fire departments don't do that type of cleaning. You need to send that off to a specialized PPE cleaner. So I am going to take apart my gear. Primarily, I'm going to do my jacket, my trousers. So I've got all my gear taken apart, including the soft components off of the helmet. So I'll go review how to do it with the pants, trousers, jacket, and then I'll go a little bit over the helmet. That can be a little tricky. Okay, so the trousers, I've removed the liners, and if you notice, these liners they're held in with snap the dot fasteners, both at the ankles and up at the waistline. So you unfasten all of that, and then you can take the liner out. Take note here, I've turned it inside out. I want the insides out. This side is got my vapor barrier, and I don't want that on the outside. I want that turned inside when I go to wash it in the machine. I've removed my my H harness, my shoulder straps that hold the trousers up, and that's it on the trousers. Okay, going up to the jacket. Once again, I've taken the liner out, turned it inside out, Same thing. This has snap the dot fasteners at the wrists, and then at the top, it's got Velcro. There's some Velcro here that goes around the collar that has to be unfastened and then snaps along the front of the jacket. So turned inside out. I got my DRD out. My jacket, any kind of closures you have on here, Velcro, zippers, refasten them all. You don't want that going back in the machine and washed, exposed. It'll damage the Velcro. And you don't want an open zipper dragging across your clothing. So fasten everything you can. Okay, helmet. We've got the Cairns 1044 model, and it has the built-in eye protection. I'm going to tell you, all I've done here is removed all of the soft products from the helmet. So my ear and neck protector, I've removed that. It's on this model, it's held in with Velcro. You're probably going to need some kind of a straight edge to get in there and release the Velcro when you take it off. So if you have to go further, get help. Don't do it yourself. Okay, so next step is I'm going to wash my liners. I'm going to do my liners. I'm going to put my DRD in there. And then I think I'm going to put my neck protector and my Nomex hood. So that's going to be one load that goes in the machine. I'm going to put my suspenders with that too. So my shells, is a load. My liners, my hood, Nomex hood, neck protector, DRD, suspenders. That's going to be a load. My soft products from my helmet, I'm not going to put those in the machine. I'm going to hand wash these. And my gloves, these are Protex. If you read the label on them, it says hand wash them. Don't machine wash them. So all this is mild detergents with this. So now the helmet. This is just, at this point, I've got all the soft products off of it. All I got to do is use a soft bristle brush and a mild detergent to clean this off inside and out, get all the buildup off on it.